Hello everybody and welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to see how to launch and play Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 on your PC. Here you can watch it on your screen. It will be possible to effortlessly download and set up Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 and enjoy the game on a Windows computer using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to the next URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type this URL, because I added the link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed here on our Usitility site, where we have a thorough summary on just how to download Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 on computer. We scroll down a bit as well as click the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we arrive here on the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to get access to that game Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 on PC. As you can see here, we access several advantages of running that emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Now we are ready to start downloading the Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 by simply clicking on this button, Download Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 on PC, that I have marked in green color. We then click on this button. And the download action takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the system. We clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installation software better. The installer is very simple. It is made up of a couple of possibilities: install and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path truly does. We simply click it. So we note that we've got here the path where the emulator can be put in. If we have to vary this directory, we have to click on the browse option, therefore we select another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we would like. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. And I simply click install. Now, before beginning setting up this emulator, it is also possible that it'll offer us more than one software deals to install on the desktop or laptop. Because I do not desire any of those software, I just click many times on the reject option. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it is going to progress together with the download of all these MB that are presented on the computer screen. The time you save it on your hard disk, it could be slightly more or less megabytes. The download speed may go faster or at a lower speed, determined by your web access and according to the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. Today they are progressing very fast. The download is finished, and so straight away it continues on with the setup step. The setup is going to take more or less time according to the power of your machine. The more efficient it really is, the shorter the software setup time and vice versa. If we merge the download and installation step, it will take a considerably long time, so be patient. It is by now completely finished on my side. Now, the emulator happens to be started on autopilot. As you can see, down here, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right when it comes to the finish, the emulator will be launched for the first time. In reality, the emulator was already started there for the very first time. So LD Store is immediately started, which is actually a sort of Google Play. It's not the smartest technique to install the game, and I really don't advise using it, since quite often the LD Store puts an out-of-date version of the game. I'll reveal to you the best way to set up the game by using Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. The first thing we have to make is to head to the computer's desktop by simply clicking this software icon that I'm pointing out in green. Before we continue, as you can see now, it created a couple of app icons right here on the computer desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player software icon is the one we are concerned about. The moment we choose to operate Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 on the PC, we double-click on this particular software icon and therefore launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything at all such as that. The reality is, it is an app icon that we will certainly never ever utilize. Let's perform the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and that's to begin to browse the Google Play Store. To do this, we will browse there to System Apps, we click on. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is started. At this point we have got to log on. At this moment, as soon as we're right here, we must definitely begin doing this following step, which is compulsory. So we mouse click on Sign In. Now it shows checking info. It might occasionally get stopped at checking info, and so it fails to advance. If so, you could attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours, but it will surely most probably be solved. Now we're going to provide our username and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address and its related password. For example, you make use of the same exact email address you are using currently in your YouTube account. So I am going to provide my info and I'll come back immediately after I have completed it. That's it, details typed. Find out Google welcoming us and supplying us the twos. We should accept all of them by clicking I agree. Next, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and this will build a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can utilize this option if you like. We click accept. The Google Play is started by default and instantly. However, if the Google Play isn't presented instantly and you do not know how to run it manually, I guide you towards how to do it now. The very first thing is to head to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this icon marked in green. At this moment we head to the System Apps folder. And we click on the Play Store icon. Alright, we are right inside of Google Play. What we shall accomplish right now is browse here to search for apps and games. And we are going to locate Mini Militia Doodle Army 2. Furthermore, there we get it, we can choose the very first result. Here we have got the Android game. How about we mouse click there on the install choice that I am just highlighting now in green. And it will commence the software setup. Right now it would download on your desktop or laptop and set up the game app. It may take a little while or it may possibly be almost immediate. This all relies upon on our own web connection. It has already completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by pressing this specific option I'm presenting in green, if you want to start Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 for the first time. We are now on the emulator desktop, and then we're preparing to mouse click on the brand new Mini Militia Doodle Army 2 icon which has been created. The video game is started for the first time. So there we get it, I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of that emulator. This is here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume, this way we are not going to depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. This is actually the very first one, we simply click on that software icon which I'm pointing out in green. And the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. In case we would like to play the app using all the screen, we press on that game icon. And we might presently be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in full screen function. To quit the full screen setting, press the F11 key. And we might currently play in standard computer screen setting. Now I am choosing to explain you the keys mapping and that is really surprisingly enjoyable. This means we will be ready to play the video game much more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this computer keyboard icon. And there you will be able to complete the appropriate controls. I'm going to let the standard configuration, however if you want to improve this, you can also achieve it without having problem. I consider this occasion to say that in certain cases, when opening the game app a dark screen comes out, if this is so and you see the black display and that emulator doesn't begin, I suggest a feasible solution. We would browse here, to the cogwheel. In the emulator options, in the advanced selection we have got quite a lot of resolutions. The following is the pixel quality that we have at the moment selected automatically and so we must select any of these other screen resolutions, for example this one below. We select it and afterwards simply click save. It will certainly require us to reboot that emulator and once restarted, most probably the emulator will start up and your black display will go away. As you can see, the emulator is entirely in our own language. In certain cases it occurs that the emulator is presented in the improper language, for example, in Chinese language. And consequently to place it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. And there throughout various other controls, we just click on the language drop down. We will select the language we want, Spanish, Chinese, and so forth. As soon as the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will restart, and the game, the next time we start it, will also be in the preferred language. At this moment, there's another thing that we need to take into consideration, and it's that we will get a message from Google Mail saying that a brand new device has been connected with this Google account. It is going to ask us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Of course, we ought not be troubled, since the emulator is behaving like an Google Android tablet or smartphone. and to find which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come back here to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Therefore we go here to the model selection, and there we realize that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for our video tutorial. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone found it handy. If so, bring it a pleasant like, subscribe, and if you have comments, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment field down below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams ever so often, you get it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Click on any of these video tutorials which are usually appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the future instructional videos. Bye.